Hello dear students, hope you are doing fine. The theme of our lesson is advice about staying healthy and active. The learning objectives are to use appropriate subject-specific vocabulary and syntax, to talk about a range of general topics and some curricular topics, to understand with little or no support more specific information in extended talk on a wide range of general and curricular topics. Okay, but first of all, I'd like you to answer such question. What should we do during the day to stay healthy and active during the quarantine? Your ideas, guys. Of course, you are right. We should do some physical activities. Eat a balanced diet, walk a lot, and can of course keep a social distance, and so on. The second question, why are we in the quarantine? Do you know? Yes, you are right, because of the COVID pandemic. That's good. Okay, next. At the end of the lesson, dear students, you will be able to give advice about staying healthy and active. Okay, before continue the lesson, let's remember some tips to stay healthy during the pandemic. Of course, you shouldn't be in a crowd. You should wear a mask. You should follow cough etiquette. You should disinfect your hands. And you shouldn't shake your hands, and you shouldn't touch your face, and you should wear gloves outside, and of course, keep distance. What would we do to stay healthy and active if the pandemic weren't? What would we do? Let's think. Okay, of course, we would include some physical activities in our day, eat a balanced diet, or maybe just follow our right daily routine. Okay, you can see some pictures. All these pictures consist of our daily routine. Your task will be to name them. First, what is it? To get up. The second, to have breakfast. The third, to go swimming, to get dressed, to eat cereals, to go jogging, to have a shower, to go to the gym, and of course no smoking. Okay. All these activities consist our right, correct daily routine. Okay, now let's think and answer the following questions. What's your daily routine like? What time do you get up? What time do you start and finish your virtual school? Do you do any activities after studying? What do you do? And of course, one question, what time do you go to bed? Okay guys, let's continue our lesson. Let's improve our listening skills. Okay, let's do pre-listening task. You should do this exercise before you listen. You should write a number from 1 to 5 to put these activities in the normal order in a day. Okay, we have such activities: get dressed and have breakfast, have classes and lunch, have dinner and watch TV, wake up and have a shower, and go to bed. How do you think? What is the first activity? Yes, you are right. The first activity is wake up and have a shower. The second activity in the order. Yes, get dressed and have breakfast. The third activity is have classes and lunch. The fourth activity is have dinner and watch TV. And the last activity is, of course, go to bed. That's good. Very good. Okay, next slide. Now let's listen to the conversation with the swimmer and answer the question.
Hello, Dan.
Hi.
Can you tell me about a typical day in your life for the school magazine?
Yeah, sure.
So, what time do you get up?
Oh, I get up very early. I get up every day at 5 o'clock and go to the pool. Then I swim from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock.
You get up at 5 o'clock? Wow, that's early.
Yeah. Then at 8 o'clock, I have a shower, I get dressed and have breakfast. I have a big breakfast. Cereals, toast, bacon and eggs and orange juice.
What do you do after breakfast?
At 11 o'clock, I go to university. I'm studying sports science and I have classes from 11 o'clock to 4 o'clock.
When do you have lunch?
I have lunch at about 2 o'clock at the university.
What do you do after classes?
Sometimes I go to the gym and sometimes I meet my friends at a cafe.
What time do you have dinner?
I have dinner at 7 o'clock. Then I watch TV or go online and I usually go to bed at 10 o'clock.
Thanks, Dan. That's a busy day.
This recording was brought to you by the British Council. To find others like it, visit www.britishcouncil.org/learnenglishteens.
Okay. While you listen, you should do this exercise. Mark the following sentences as true or false. If the answer is false, you should explain why it is incorrect. Okay, first sentence. Dan gets up early. The second, he has a small breakfast. The third, he's a student. The fourth, Dan has lunch at home. He goes swimming after classes. And the last one, Dan watches TV and goes on the internet before bed. Now, let's listen and mark. Okay, let's check your answers. The first sentence is true. That's good. The second sentence is false. Why? Because he has a big breakfast. He has bacon, eggs, cereals, orange juice for breakfast. Yes? Good. Okay, the third sentence is true. That's good. The fourth is false. Why? Because he has lunch at university. The fourth is false. Why? Because he goes swimming before class in the early morning. And the last one is true. Very good job, guys. Let's do one more exercise while you listen. Here you should fill in the gaps with an activity from the box to complete Dan's diary. At 5 a.m. gets up. At 6 a.m. Dan goes swimming. At 8 a.m. Dan has breakfast. At 11 a.m. Dan goes to university. At 2 p.m. Dan has lunch. At 5 p.m. Dan meets friends. And the last one, at 7 p.m. Dan has dinner. Very good. And now let's do a reflection. Can you answer such questions? What has been learned? What remained unclear? What is necessary to work on? If you answer this question, you reached your aims. Okay, your home task. Your home task will be to write some recommendations to stay healthy and active year round. Okay, our lesson is over. Thank you for your job. keep up healthy lifestyle and stay healthy.